Thank you. We are now live here at Kettering in the National Volleyball Center for our second game of the Women's Māori Super League opening weekend. Cambridge ARU will be taking on reigning champions Durham Palatinates. But first, the lineup introductions. First up, we've got lineup introductions for Cambridge ARU.
Yeah.
there is the first point of the game. Going to Cambridge, ARU, who will be trying to cause an upset here against the previous double champs, Durham Palatinates. Brilliant swing down the line, picked up. Free ball for Cambridge. Great swing from the pipe, finds the deep corner there. Palamin showing us how it's done. Kofescu is there again. And it's a brilliant roll shot into the area of uncertainty by Carfino. Kofescu there time and time again in transition, giving Durham the opportunity to convert some big transition points. Picked up by Carfino. Free ball for Durham now. Slide attack. Great block touch by Cambridge. Swing down the line is picked up again. What a rally this is. Carfino with another roll shot there, showing us how to remain calm in such a scrappy rally. Brilliant play by her again. Good ball in. Tip is picked up by Durham. Dump picked up by Kovescu. And this time, Jade Turner finds the area of the court that is open to her with a cheeky set over from a C quick. Ball in, runs the slide, is picked up by Cambridge. 101 line shot is good from Palamin, leading her team as the captain. Good ball in by Brand. Tip right into the corner of the net. Way to be aware by Jake Turner again. This time tipping it short. Up by Kofescu, and it ends up an error on Cambridge's side. Kofescu nearly diving that pass, but good movement nevertheless. Tight pass, and it results in an ace for Jake Turner. good serving by the middle. In system for Cambridge. Bit of miscommunication and it's picked up by Jake Turner. And a little miscommunication on both sides there. Both setters seem to have a bit of a different idea than the hitter. But I'm sure they will both figure things out between the hitter. Just a matter of communication. And it's a cheeky dump behind her head. Number 10, Stanton. Showing that you don't have to necessarily dump it hard. You can tip it right behind her head into the corner. Covered up by Durham, and the deep corner tip goes out. A rare time we'll see a deep corner tip from a slide attack. Never mind setting the ball to that deep corner too. It's a good roll shot from the back row by Palamin. Both teams struggling to stay in system here. Cambridge taking the lead right now. Palamin on the service line delivered a good float serve, catching Covescu high. And this one, with the dump, Cambridge claiming that they saw a touch, but it's a great standing dump by Stanton there. Great adjustment by the setter there. Leomidi finding her middle. And Tladowska finding the gap between the two blockers and adjusting to that slightly off pass. Carpino finds the high hand swing, clips the fingers of Cambridge, and it's a point for Durham again. Carpino showing some great range with his hitting at the her hitting at the moment. High hands and roll shots. Maybe he'll mix in a bounce. Thank you. Good ball in by Brand. Orfino's roll shot misses this time. Rare for her this set so far. Still a back and forth game. Parfino this time showing a bit more aggression. Hits a high off the hands. Making up for that error earlier. By Clovescu. Slide attack. Blocked by Cambridge. Well washed there by both Cambridge blockers. Zlodowska getting the block there. Slide attack just misses out this time. Good block touch. Transition for Cambridge. Shoot set is blocked. Jade Turner taking some revenge on that one. Great sharp angle swing, but it's picked up by Brand. And it is a block again by Durham. Bitkin's first block of the game. Free ball, Durham transition opportunity. Finds deep into area six. Bitkin adjusting well to the set. Snapping her wrist down, and it forces a timeout for Cambridge ARU. Setter is still back row, so three options to side out with. Stevens from back court, picked up well by Cambridge. That one ends on Cambridge's side. Cambridge claiming that it hit the antenna, which would result in Durham's loss at that point, but let's see what the referees end up deciding here. Still Durham's point after deliberating with the line judge. The ball was not deemed to be hit on the antenna. Jake Turner up to serve. Brand sides out, blocked out this time. Great transition points. Started Parfino's, great pass. Pipe opportunity, clips the hands. Carfino doing it front court, back court, it does not matter. She'll find your hands and earns the point for Durham as well as a timeout. In, but it's too tight for Cambridge. Backcourt setter, which means that he couldn't attack the ball there. Better ball in this time. A slide for an opposite. Porcher gets it done. Starts off inside, maybe tricking the block into an inside set, then running to the outside. It's cross court, gets the point. Ball in. Recycled. So it might be a free ball for Durham. Transition after transition. What a rally this is. But it ends on a net touch, unfortunately. Both teams hustling very well to pick up everything in their sight. And it's an ace! Cambridge celebrating that one as Palamin, their captain, get the ace. Serve drops just short of Covescu there. That ball had so much movement and just tied down right in front of Durham. System swing, but it's well picked up by Covescu. Free ball for Cambridge now. That swing sails out. Excuse me. That one sails, just touches Stevens there. And Cambridge's defense has been rewarded there. Some picked up by Covescu. Great transition. And it is a dunk. From out of nowhere, the setter cheekily earns Durham their first set point of the game. What a play there by Lumini to protect the first set point. Cheekily dumping it behind her head with one hand. Nobody there. And she's now up to serve. Great swing by Stevens. Goes through the hand of the block. And Durham have set one. Cambridge showing some flashes, but occasionally when they gain momentum, they have struggled to keep that. So it is up to them now to try and maintain momentum when they can in the second set. Second set coming soon to you after this break. And we are back into the second set of this game. Good ball in from Cambridge. And it's a brilliant swing cross court. Huffman gets the job done. That's what happens when you get a great in-system swing as well, which I think they've been struggling with. Serve receive is so crucial at this level of the game. Great swing by Stevens, recognizing the line that the block left them with, and capitalizes on it. And that is a roof on top of Gamer's head. Great block by Jake Turner, staying disciplined on the tip and just dunking the ball down. Great tip into the circle of uncertainty. Hoffman earned another point for her team. Straight in the seam. Parfino adjusts well, jumping off one leg and finding the gap in the block. Against a triple block, Jake Turner finds a way, and that all started from the pass by Covescu there, giving it at the perfect height for his setter to make the correct decision. Durham are really finding their rhythm in transition now. Couple points from Jake Turner at the service line. And it's an ace. Never mind. Cambridge pick it up somehow, and it results in a point. Confusion on Durham's side, and Cambridge have been rewarded for their hustle. Locked on, but picked up brilliantly by Covescu. And it's a block out for Cambridge. Big momentum built on their side now from that big hustle play from before, and then that block almost blocking the dump by Shenton. Catches the defender on the way. Big point by Alice Brand, trying to get Durham riled back up. What a pickup by Cambridge. Durham now have to transition. Roll shot picked up by the setter. And it's a brilliant point again by Palamin. Really converting at a high efficiency in transition. That was a brilliant pickup by Belly, the libero, as well. Cambridge really starting to enjoy themselves in this game. Gets the ace. The moment that ball left her hands, it just began to move and dip. Better ball in this time. One-on-one. Bounces it in front of Durham. Huffman making up for his fellow teammate's mistake earlier. That's what volleyball is all about. You can always make up for your errors for your teammates or for yourself the next point. And it's a monster block. Yeniak this time blocking with her teammate. Inside set, not working out for Durham that time. That swing deep into the end line. Carfino showing her range when hitting. Great pickup by Lipkin. And it's a swing and a half. Straight through both seams, the block and the defense. Cambridge can't do anything about that one. But it's also a brilliant pickup by Litkin in transition. Gives her team the best chance possible. Roll shot is picked up by Belly. Sharp angle is picked up again. Block covered somehow, but it's a free ball for Cambridge. One-on-one block covered by Belly. Free ball, Durham. Great pickup by Palamin. What a rally this is. Another chance. Tip goes into the net. What a long rally. Unfortunate ending, but that's what happens. When you have such long rallies, you begin to get worn out, and that one might just be a sign of it. Ball in. Set was inside, but Stevens finds a way to tip it into area one. Double sub coming on for Durham. And it looks to be a substitution for the setter and the opposite, giving Durham three options in the front court. Setter, Lobby on the serve now. Inside set ran double quick in front and behind the setter. A lot of stress on the blocker, especially if the middle blocker isn't supporting you. That outside hitter has to block both the quicks that Cambridge just ran. Ace serve for Huffman. Love that celebration by Cambridge there. Slight attack. Brilliant point by Durham. Lob just came on, but she's already showing that she's not afraid to use a slide attack, even though she's slightly off the net. Transition for Cambridge. And it's a block out by Palamin. She's been showing us how it's done. Early on in this game, she's been showing a lot of power. This one, she swings off the hands. Great swing one-on-one, but well picked up there too. Tip is good by Palamin. Setter chases the ball all over the court. Well done by Leomidi, trying to keep his hitters in rhythm and giving them the best shot to make the point. Ball-in results in an effective middle play. Litkin getting the job done there. Double substitution. Back on comes Stevens and Stanton. Three attackers front row again now. So this might be a chance for Durham to pull away. Swing down the line, picked up by the setter. Another great pickup by Cambridge. And that one is called out of bounds. Ball goes just outside the antenna there. Point for Durham. Great pickup by Kofescu, but out of system for Durham. Free ball, trying to set directly over into the deep corner. Covered up. Transition for Cambridge. That one is a rare error there by Palamin. Timeout called by the coach of Cambridge, maybe to try and give his players a breather. Yeah. a 2-point lead for Durham now. Starting to get a bit worried that Durham were able to pull away. That service error may just be what Cambridge needed there. Good ball in by Brand. Stevens is blocked by Cambridge. Another monster block. Cambridge getting a couple big blocks, and this one comes at a very crucial time. That roll shot is good from Huffman. Way to identify the donut, as some call it. The circle of uncertainty in the defense. Great pickup by Kofescu. And it's another block. This time on the other side from Huffman. Blocks Alex Brand, and it is a timeout for Durham. First timeout of the game from Durham, and Cambridge will be looking to keep this momentum going. Good ball in by Kofescu, bit off the net. Brand hits over the block. Try and halt the momentum from building anymore. And now she's up to serve. This one is called a carry. All smiles as everybody knows that that was the right call. But Durham now earned the first crucial point in the 20s. And it is another forced error by Alice Brand serve. Timeout called by Cambridge. They'll need to try and get their serve-receive unit in order before they head out again. Still an out-of-system play, and it's a free ball for Durham. Lifkin throws it down. It's another great pickup by Durham. But this time, Carfino swings out. Cambridge finally earning the side-out point they've been looking for. Ball picked up by Carfino there, and it's dumped into the block. Great point by Stevens. Yeah. results in an error. That brings set point for Durham to go 2-0 up. Pitkin up to serve now. Great pickup by Litkin, but no one is there to connect it. Showing some great movement, even though Libero isn't on court. And now that Kofescu's on, chances of side out is probably also better, as they have better strength in serve received now. It's a dump, but well picked up by Belly. Stevens to swing down the line off the outside hand of the blocker, and it is set 2 to Durham. Cambridge built up some momentum, but they will be looking for that reverse sweep in the next set.
Thank you.
brilliant swing from the side out, high tempo offense ran to perfection there, and we are back into the third set in full swing. Touch called against Cambridge this time, and it is 4-1, Durham. Great serve again. Palamin's swing catches the hands of the defender. Ball in by Kofescu. And Brand speeds up to the set. Well ran tempo offense by Hannah Lowe. Newly put in the set. Great block touch, but it's a bit of a scramble for Durham here. Free ball for Cambridge. And that swing goes just out. Cambridge unable to convert that one. Great serve drifts away from the defender. That is an ace for Jake Turner. What a serve. Flat, with barely any spin on the ball. Drifts away from the Cambridge defender. And again, that's two in a row. Another one for Jake Turner. Again, but well passed this time. Unfortunately, it results in a net touch by Leomidi. Great serve again. Only a free ball for Durham now. Pass too tight though. Hellman shows no mercy, dumps it down. Stevens dodges that one narrowly. That swing goes just out. Palamin trying to go for the line. Very aggressive swing, just lacking a little bit of execution. Serve goes deep, but is well passed by Cambridge. What a pickup by Kofescu, but no one is there to keep that one up. Great touch there, nevertheless. That's what liberals are all about, trying to keep the ball alive for their teammates. And it is a block by Leomidi, the setter. Well, the spin block. And it was also great service pressure applied to give them an out-of-system opportunity. Short serve is good. Great serve by Palamin. Drops it just in front of the 3-meter line. Great swing, side out, ran to perfection. That flat serve delivered straight to Alice Brand, crushes it, cross court, one-on-one, no chance for Cambridge. For Cambridge now. Lead getting a bit too big for Cambridge's liking. Let's see how they can adjust to Durham. Can't connect to that one. Alice Brand is too much from the service line right now. Well adjusted, but it's picked up by Brand. And it is a great transition play. Litkin on the finishing end on that one. Great swing by Hoffman between the block, deep down the line. Touch out and a point for Cambridge. Finally getting a point out of that timeout. Let's see whether they can build some momentum from this point. Stevens is blocked but covered. And it is a point for Cambridge. That all started with the block. Great serve into the seam. It's high ball for Durham. Stevens tips, but it is picked up. Recycled by Cambridge. Harfinos is blocked by Leomidi. That set left Carfino really no option. That is a great block by Cambridge. Nevertheless, double block, no way through. And it is a big rally point for them.
Smart talk.
Tabor and Bellino substituted into the game. First point results in an error. But with a new opposite on court, let's see what Aver can do in this game. Blocked, well picked up by the libero. Unfortunately, nobody could connect to that one. Haber nearly picking that one up. Good ball in by Brand. Well picked up by Cambridge though. Roll shot into the circle of the defense. Tip right into the donut. Farfino swings on the hands and it is a block out, side out that Durham really needed there. Aver, the lefty opposite, first time serving in this game, aims for the seams and results in an overpass. Picked up Scrapley, but unfortunately they couldn't get that one over. Well chased by Belly, and also a pretty good up by Horcher considering the situation, getting it up with a chicken wing. Fino finds a deep corner, but well picked up by Belly. Free ball, Durham. Slide attack down the line. Super spike for Jake Turner. Running towards the right side, finds the gap that the blocker left him, and shows no mercy. And it's an ace for Farfino. That serve just drifted outside the arms of Hoffman. Timeout for Cambridge. Durham have already hit the 20-point mark now. And these points are going to be more and more crucial. Onto court they go. Cambridge have three options in the front row right now, so let's see if they can side out here. And that is crushed cross court by Palament. Brand with the deep corner swing picked up though. One up, well picked up by Aber. Great pickup by Haber. And it is dunked down by Sladowska on Cambridge. Great rally and defensive plays on Durham's side. Trying to keep the ball alive. This time Cambridge gets the better of them. And it is a brilliant first ball over by Liam Meadey. What a cheeky play from the setter there. Realizes the deep corner is completely wide open after that rally. Nobody there. Why not send it there then? What a pickup by Cambridge from that venomous swing. And they are rewarded. Brilliant transition run. Durham are forced to timeout. What a swing by Jake Turner, but unfortunately the Cambridge middle were able to somehow pick it up. No lib on court, no problem, says Cambridge. Back on court, and let's see if Menegazzo can serve up some defensive brilliance again. Great serve, catches them high. High hand swing is good for Alice Brand. Maybe that England experience is coming in handy now as both teams enter into the crucial part of the set. Now a substitution for Sutki coming on. Probably a serving specialist or defensive specialist coming in place of Jake Turner in the middle. Great serve, but a better pass. And it is a pick up, but it results in a net touch by Durham. An incredibly well-run offense, Cambridge. Porter running right behind the setter. Double quick again. But she comes off for number four. Jashali up to serve. Set goes inside, but she tips away from his body. Excuse me, she tips away from her body, finds the corner of the 3-meter line. Laue up to serve. Durham have three options, but Cambridge are able to take advantage of a dump in this situation. Great pickup by Haver. Pipe attack is picked up by Belly. Another great pickup by Haver, but Durham have to connect to that one. Free ball for Cambridge. What a pickup by Belly. And Cambridge are rewarded again for their scrappy play. Great hustle and scrappiness, but more importantly, the tenacity they've shown over this game has rewarded them time and time again. Catches the hands, and Durham are now 23, only 2 points left for match point. Cambridge have shown to be a real threat, especially in these long rallies that we've been seeing all game. Great ball in. Hoffman choose to roll, and it is a net touch by Durham again. Cambridge will take those errors any day, and these points are being more and more amplified at the moment. Ladovska up to serve, no lib on court, but it hasn't been a problem before. Great pickup. Ladovska swings from the pipe. It is a net touch this time by Cambridge. Both sides maybe being worn out by the long rallies they've been trading. So it might be a matter of endurance. But up comes match points for Durham. Bell to serve. Brilliant serve, but a better pass. Transition is picked up, but a foot fault called. Going a bit too far under the net. A rare error to be called. But nevertheless, Durham have the chance to side out here for match point. Great pickup by Cambridge. Libero spikes it. High ball to Hoffman. Great pickup by Carfino, but nobody is there to follow up. Huge points for Cambridge to earn themselves another chance at taking back this set. Durham are forced to time out. We'll see whether this also ices the server. Miri up to serve. There's setter who's been so consistent this set. Let's see. Tip is picked up by Cambridge. Transition. Pipe attack is good. Well adjusted there by Palamin there. Off one foot. Gets the block touch. And it is deuce. Tiebreaker in the third set of this game. Great pass by Carfino. Nobody up, but the set was a low and a net touch is called against Durham. Cambridge might have a chance now. First advantage of the game and match set point, excuse me, for Cambridge. Great pickup by Cambridge. Hoffman with the swing. It is picked up somehow by Cambridge. Durham go again and get the point in transition. Cambridge just don't seem to be ever giving up, picking up the ball any way they can. What? A serve. Stevens floats that serve. Probably moving trajectory maybe three times on the course. Gives Durham the match point they've been craving for. Slide attack is blocked. An absolute monster block to get Cambridge back level. They seem to have figured out the slide attack from Durham. slide attack again. Roll shot is picked up by Belly. And it is swung, touches, called. Portia gets the point, and it is advantage Cambridge again. Set point for them. Free ball, Cambridge. And Liumi gets the point. First ball over, sets it deep corner. Hesitation all around for Durham. They'll be disappointed to lose that one, but they must remember they'll need one more set to win this match, and they've got two chances to do so. On the other end, Cambridge can take all the positives from this set. They fought hard and well to get back into this game. Set three to Cambridge ARU, and I'm sure they will be trying to carry that momentum on to get the reverse sweep. The fourth set we go. Durham will want to negate any chance Cambridge have, but Cambridge has all the momentum right now. And the first point goes to Cambridge. Brilliant deep swing by Palamon. Stevens just about gets the ball through the block, swiping it across her body. Good ball in to the outside. Well picked up by Brand. And Carfini tries the cross-court swing. just about misses. And that was a great pickup by Brand from area 6. Great pass by Kofescu. Slide ran to near perfection, let's say. Hoffman nearly picking that one up, but well done to Jake Turner for identifying the seam in the block and just trying to tap it down. And it is a block for Jake Turner. Following the middle and just reaching over to block that A-quick. Bit of miscommunication on Cambridge's side. Alice Brand just about can't capitalize on that one. Porter probably thought the Omidi was going to set an inside ball like they have been the last couple times they've run it, but I'm sure they'll communicate better and get the point next time. Great flat serve results in a free ball for Durham. Slide attack, blocked. And it is a great swing by Palamin down the line. Great block touch there by Cambridge. Slide attack, still running in rhythm, but the conversion rate might have been dropping now. Brand gets the swing on the outside hand. Mini all smiles. Love that she's enjoying the game, even though you might think the Super League is an intense league. But the love of the game always comes first. Great pick up there, dumped over by Litkin. Swing but picked up. What a pick up again. Block out off the hands of Litkin. Scrappy play again. We're starting to see flashbacks of the last set. High swing goes deep and over the block. Great side out from an out of system play. And that serve goes just in. Alice Brand with a deep float serve, dropping it right on the end line. Couple of service errors now, but point difference stays consistent, so it'll be up to each team to try and find a breakaway. Great swing by Huffman. Let's see if that sharp angle swing can spark anything on Cambridge's side. Stevens with the swing high off the hands, and Palamon just can't pick it up. Deep serve again, catches them off guard. Durham seems to be serving deep consistently now. We'll find out whether that was a game plan after serving a couple short aces previously. Maybe Cambridge made an adjustment to shift up when passing the serve, but so far they'll need to adjust again in this timeout. Ball in this time. Double quick, but it is called a double. Much better pass this time though, so I'm gonna guess the goal of the timeout was achieved. Take a bit of an open stance when passing that deep float serve, and that one worked out well. Garfino squeezes that in between the block. Durham getting their mojo back. Or shall I say, getting into a bit of a rhythm. Cambridge still haven't sided out. And this time they side out. Porcher gets the job done, telling her team, relax, she's got him. Brilliant high ball set as well from the libero, Belly, giving her hitter enough time to adjust and see the block. Ends in a line shot squeezed right past the double block. Palamon really showing us that she can squeeze the line shot through anything at the moment. Great pickup by Covescu. Dump is blocked, picked up somehow. And a net touch from Cambridge. Well covered by Durham, and a brilliant pickup by Covescu from that tough serve. Tight pass, picked up through a pancake. Brand swings deep, right in between the seams of the defense and the block. gets the point for Durham. At first, serve receive was just a bit too tight for Liamini, the backcourt setter, to get a hand on. Serves front court, so look out for some dumps. Alice Brand with a deep corner swing goes in. That England national team experience paying off there. Great pickup by Kofescu, one-handed. But it results in a free ball for Cambridge. And it is brilliantly tooled off the hands. Throws it into the block. First time we've seen an intentional tool by Halliman. Showing that she's not all about power. Nobody up, and it is a monster spike by Stevens. Brilliant set by Lob. No blockers up, and it's easy pickings for Durham. Misplay ended in a dump, technically, by Liamini. Not sure if that was intentional, but points are not worth complaining about. On comes Natasha Frost, youngest player on the Cambridge squad, 2006. Float serve goes at Kofescu. And that one drifts out. First serve for Frost. Let's see how she does this time. Crowd cheering her on. That one's in the net, unfortunately. Carfino cuts it down the line, well picked up though. High ball for Carfino, tries to find the deep corner. Brilliant swing from Pipe, picked up by Alice Brand. It's a free ball for Cambridge. Another pickup by Brand. And it is a point for Durham. Durham showing some tenacity there, showing that they can be as tenacious as Cambridge have been in the last set. Brand picking up everything from Area 6 with one arm. Timeout called now for Cambridge. Before you know it, we've hit 21-14, or Durham lead by 7. These points will be ever so crucial for Cambridge to try and build upon, but it is looking a little unlikely that they will be able to pull off that reverse sweep. One-handed dump is picked up by Durham, and it is blocked, so it was a bit too tight. Good ball in with time to spare. Parfino tips it into the block. Cambridge scramble, but just can't get it over the net. Even in system, Carfino finds a way to be as unpredictable as anybody else. That is a swing down the line. Palamon just loves that line shot. No matter what situation, she is going to crush it down the line. Great ball in by Kofescu. Slide attack. Tips it right over the two blockers. Finesse shown there by Jake Turner. And that serve lands right in the deep corner for Jake Turner. Match point again for Durham.
Here we go. Match point once again for Durham.
They'll be hoping to end it right here. Good ball in system. Slide attack. Dump picked up by Belly. Picked up again by Belly. And that one hits the antenna, and it is a point for Durham, and it is the match to Durham as well. The defending champions get off to a great start in their Super League campaign, but Cambridge have shown some great tenacity, improving upon the scoreline from last season, and I'm sure they'll have a lot of positives to pick up on for this coming Super League campaign. Up next, we will have Leeds Gorse up against Side Out Polonia. That will be a big matchup against the runner-up of last season, Team Side Out, that is. And I'll be looking forward to seeing you there. Bye-bye.